Now, our first play is being performed by Adam and Anne, and it's called Mark Antony's Women Take Aim. Now, it's lovely tonight that we've actually got the writer of this play, who has come from Melbourne to be present and to see it, and so we'd like to welcome Bob Callaghan.
Rob
Callaghan. We'll get it right on the fourth run.
Divine in his uniform, with
this long, wavy hair, this wild and ferocious expression. Why did he want to leave you? That's the question.
Oh, it was all my fault. I never taught him to stay. Stay! Came home from the forum one day to a scroll. Duty calls. Be back soon. Don't wake up!
Oh, Fulvia! That's awful. What a bastard.
And after everything I did for him, 8 legions I raised for him to smite his foes and his rivals who were threatening his interests. Oh, did he show an interest? Come back to help? Oh, making war used to be his favourite thing to do.
8 legions? Isis? Did you ever command them in battle?
You think I am? Huh. Commander in chief. That was me.
Oh, I've commanded troops in battle. Such a heady feeling.
You?
Commanded litter bearers, maybe.
But it's true.
Mm-hmm.
Not as many as 8 legions, but sometimes, 20,000 men. Oh, I used to parade in my war chariot in front of my army to inspire the men and call down blessings upon our cause and yell, "Charge!" Then I'd be whisked away to a safe hill where I couldn't see the action.
Oh, they never let me into the thick of it either, my centurions. Oh, they knew I'd thrash any one of them one-on-one, by Jupiter. But then, it was essential to preserve my military brain from the misfortune of a lucky strike by the enemy. Oh. Unlikely, I know, but I saw it. Never missed the executions, though. Oh, the mass executions.
You, I can see what Mark meant.
What do you mean by that?
Nothing. Did you ever consider that maybe Mark was bored of coming home to a wife whose tunic was more covered in gore than he had on his?
He never mentioned it.
Maybe he was afraid of hurting you.
Afraid of meeting my 8 legions, more likely. That boy was the best general in Rome, till he met you. All that soft living and fancy feasts and 1,000 diversions. Right, ruined the fighting man. Oh, but Cleo. Can I call you Cleo? Cleo. I can't stay angry with you forever. We're so much alike.
We are?
How? 2 strong women. Holding our own, living as we please. Beholden to no man in a world full of bastards. Most women are fey, helpless creatures. Servants. Slaves, but we are queens.
Well, one of us is a queen. The other merely controls 8 legions, but I see your point. We're sisters. Oh, Cyrus, is there any Lou Papyrus out there?
Besides, we have a common enemy.
We do?
Well, think about it. Who did he have while you were languishing in Alexandria?
Octavia!
Octavia!
Bitch!
Witch!
Whore!
Harpy!
Harlot!
Ugh. She wasn't a harlot. Or a whore. Could you fix this for me? No, she was more like an envious, arrogant, two-faced, goody two-sandaled ice block.
Well, she slept with my husband.
Your husband? He was my husband. His third marriage, but the most important. And he only had 4. He never married you.
That's what you think. If your arrogant senate of Rome had recognized my marriage, it was like it never happened. Anyway, what's your beef with Octavia? Weren't you dead by the time you married her?
Well, technically. But I was still hanging round. Hadn't found this place yet. Oh, I saw what she did to my children when she adopted them, turning them into hoity-toity little violets. She made them read Cicero. Cicero! Oh, when my Mark had him killed for me, they brought his head to me, and I took great pleasure in piercing his poisoned tongue with my hairpins. Great pleasure.
Go, girl. You rock. Hey, do you think we might see Mark here?
I doubt it. Bacchus told me Mark had been sent to the afterlife.
The afterlife?
Mm-hmm.
So if Mark was sent to the afterlife, where are we?
Oh, the after party!
Hey, there's some hot guys here. Have you seen Adonis?
Oh, Adonis. My girlfriend's been with him. Let's just say he hasn't got any more than one arrow in his quiver. And when he's used that all up, he has no more arrows, has he? I am going to parade back and forth past Apollo's booth.
Oh, I love Greek men. Let's go.
Let's go.
Mark would have loved the after party.
Yes. Serves him right.